Also, everybody is putting names, even for dogs, even for cats, they are having names. Putting names is entirely different from substantializing a person by a name. What is the purpose of calling person by his name? There are three things. One, unless a person is named or branded, according to Shastra, he is known as Anapahata Papma. If he is not branded with a name, he is not accounted for the subtle deeds of his Sharira. That is a very great thing. Anapahata papma vaham, so says Rudra in Shatapatha Brahmana. So, whenever a person is named ceremonially, not naming a person as William Rock, Joseph Stone, innumerable names are there, they don't possess any meaning at all. So, naming a person ceremonially by application of water, by application of mantras, by application of representations, by application of gesticulations in mudra, through the sacramental and sacred fire, systematically giving a person this type of nomenclature that removes all the sins of the person. Number two, any person getting a name gets a divine sanction for his karma. First thing is eradication of sin and getting also a spiritual identity. That type of spirit which is sent by God to reside inside this body, to sojourn inside the body for a stipulated period is branded with the name. So that sin of not being named is eradicated by naming. Number two, whenever a person's archana, sankalpa, vrata, anushtana, tarpana, whatever we do only with the connectivity of the name. So without which the spiritual sanction is neglected. So our naming is entirely different from social identity. Just for voter's ID, just for getting an attendance register, official attendance, then ration card. This thing is no doubt it serves also that purpose, but we have a religious purpose of eradication of sins and qualification of a person to do spiritual rites and connectivity of a person with this transcendental lineage of rishis as well as the pitrus. So whenever a person's name is uttered, these things occur. The final benefit is Bhagavan Namo Charana Palam. We should not name, see, there are everything is God. But that which directly denotes God, we have to do that. There are innumerable types of naming people. There are five types of naming. Number one, Antaryami, Amsha, Pratinidhi, Parikara, Sakshat. Antaryami means God resides in everything. God resides in mud. So you cannot put your name as mud. God, no doubt God resides in mud also, but it should directly denote. See, you should be so capable to realize that God is also in mud, I am calling mud, I am thinking of mud, but I am thinking only of God. That is a divine state which cannot be possible to you or even to all. You may be calling yourself as mud, thinking God, but others cannot do that. So your name must not only make you to think of God, should also be a good reminder of divinity and divine connection. So for that, mud, stone, rock, everything is antaryam. God resides inside, you should not name that. And Amsha, God is there in sun, star, moon. Lot of people they are doing like Surya, Chandra, they are also naming, that is actually different. And third thing is Pratinidhya. Pratinidhya means God is there in form of lot of abstracts like Veera, Shaurya, Gambhirya, Vikrama, Parakrama, Karuna, Shanta, Datrutva, Vatsalya, Saushilya, Saukumarya, Gambhirya, Aujwalya, Saugandhya. These are the qualities of God. You can name Sugandh, means it is a quality of God. That is a Pratinidhya, that represents a God. So, having an abstract nomenclature which represents a divine multiplicity or divine opulential immanence, that is also a name. And Lokesha, Sarvalokeshwara, Maheshwara, these type of names of God, they just give the idea about divine office, that he is governing everything, he knows everything, he rules everything, he is above for all of us. So, these things are also the divine nomenclatures. But directly mentioning God as Lakshmipati, that's what Asadharana Linga means to say, that which cannot be attributed to somebody else, that which we cannot attribute to somebody else, that which is non-ambiguous, non-obscure, that which is directly reminding God, that is known as Sakshat, that means of Srinivasa, Narayana, Vasudeva, Vaikunthanalaya, Garudharuda, Srivatsanga, Kaustubhadara, Gadadhari, Chakrapani, these terms are directly denoting God. So, nomenclature also, we can probably think of designing ourselves with divine nomenclature. And Namakarana, somebody asked, Swami, we are giving good names and they are behaving in such a manner that the name itself is corrupted. So, we have given them the names, thinking that the name will sanctify them. But these people, they have extra sanctified the name itself. That is what we used to say in Shastras. If a person, he should have both the ends. If the Namakarna is between the rails of previous and post samskaras, then the people will be, the persons who have been named will be very much suitable to the name. If the person is named Karunamurti, then certainly if the person has followed that particular samskaras of Annaprashana, particular samskaras of Garbhadana, everything, etc. If the all the previous samskaras are perfectly done, and after Namakarana, you see, only by making, for example, if it is a silver tumbler, if I am calling it as gold, then there is no possibility to think that it is gold, or practically we cannot see anything in it. But if there is any alchemical process by which it is converted into gold, any rasaveda or rasabhara, there is a possibility. Likewise, each and every human is also asuric in nature. That should be a ritualistic alchemical process by which the divine qualities are imbibed and installed inside. So, the previous samskaras should qualify the person to bear the name. And the post samskaras after the Namakarana should qualify the person to create a name for the name. To have this Arthakarana of Namadheya, that is to make the name really befitting. So even after nomenclature, we have to follow all these. Annaprashana. You see, according to the common observation, food gives only nutrition. According to our Shastras, food can give you knowledge. If proper Annaprashana is done, that is what we call the Medha Dana. It is known as Medha Dana. When the child is born after the Jatakarma, Ayushya, Matru Prasamsha and Medha Dana is given. What is Medha Dana? By uttering the Veda mantras, Bhagya Vachaspati mantras, drops of honey and ghee in a bowl drink is mixed, and with the fourth finger, it is applied to the tongue of the child with mantras. It is known as Medha Dana. I am giving you Medha. This, see, there are three things. Whenever you are having the habit of drinking coffee, whenever you are seeing somebody drinking coffee, you are stimulated. The coffee time automatically, the alarm inside the rings. Likewise, anybody who is given the Medha Dana, naturally, whenever he sees a book, till he finishes, he won't keep it down, number one. Whenever he hears a lecture, he won't turn his face unless he completely do that, hears that. Third, whenever he sees a guru, he will not leave him till he extracts the holiest wisdom. Number four, whenever he takes a spiritual process, he won't be away from the path till he accomplishes. This type of commitment, this type of strength or this type of staunchness comes only to people, those who are given that Medha Dana. So, like a coffee stimuli, like the instigation for alcoholism and addiction, a divine addiction or intellectual addiction is incorporated inside Medha Dana. If it is ceremonially, ritualistically, properly, if it is done, exercise at that age itself, then the child becomes naturally addictive to intellectual circumstances and spiritual grounds. It tastes only divine food. It seeks the shelter and guidance of only divine people. Naturally, just as this cow and other things, they are naturally herbivorous in nature. They cannot be compelled to take some meat or something. That means naturally the person is tuned to go for divine adoption. Naturally the person is evincing repulsion against non-divine and mundane things. So that is known as Medha Dana, Ayushya and Matru Prasamsha. So this type of Annaprashana, in our Annaprashana, along with the food, we can do three things. By mixing mantra, tantra and black magic, you can give food to somebody and we can do Bhedana. Bhedana, Vashikarana, Marana. In Mantra Shastra they say that you mix Marana mantra, give the food, he will die. You mix Bhedana mantra, he will become a lunatic if he is not already. Third thing, Vashikarana, he will be listening to you. In spite of you being distant or proximate, he will obey your thought or your action. He will imitate your action, he will obey your thought, he will obey your orders in presence. So that is possible. In Mantra Shastra it says that Marana, Vashya and Vibhedana is possible. Like that in spirituality we say that Jnana, Bhakti and Moksha is possible by Prasada. By consuming